excellent fruits that are God given blessing for all of us here. So in terms of cashews, we have created a fruit drink, a sort of a version of Nero as we know it. But that has a shelf life of 6 months and available throughout the year. We have cashew apple chutney which is there. We've created cashew butter. We of course have seasoned cashews in our portfolio. We are also coming out with cashew apple sauce. Excellent sauce can be made out of it. So we are doing R&D on that butter. Along with this, we have in our portfolio fruit beverages made out of bimli, made out of kokum, out of jackfruit. We have jams, we have chutneys, and we also are developing a lot of other snacks out of these fruit products. So that is the first step, development of the product. Second is, I was talking about the lack of knowledge about all of this. So how do you educate the customers? How can you create a market of it? That's a major challenge. I mean, you can making product, as we have seen, is the easier part of it. Creating a market is the difficult part of it. So we have tackled that in our own way. The third is we have created the infrastructure. We have developed manufacturing technologies adopted from whatever is available in the market to manufacture all of these products on a commercial scale. Now, another important part is this is again a work in progress for us to create a supply chain right from the farmers to factory. So we have created and in the process of creating cold storage infrastructure, transport and logistics to handle that issue. Now coming to the market part of it, which I said is the most critical missing piece in this. We have, after the product development, we have focused on developing Goan Fest as a brand. And in developing that Goan Fest as a brand, we have benchmarked ourselves against the top of the line companies globally as well as in India. So in terms of the product quality, by that I mean the taste and flavor profile and nutritional value, we know we are one of the best in the world. Along with that, we have appropriate packing technologies, labeling technologies, packing, labeling to one, increase the shelf life and make it into a world-class looking product in terms of branding and marketing effort. So the effort is to make Goan Fest into a premium, well-known brand, not only in India, but globally.
Thank you so much. This is really inspiring and incredible what you have achieved. And you know, for those of you who are not familiar with their products, next time you take a flight from Mopar to Andaman, you will find your products on the flight, I believe. Right? Congratulations for that. Thank you. So now I have a. कितलो वेळ असा आमका अकॉर्डिंगली असा ओके सो आणि 5 मिनिटं एक सो थँक्यू फॉर युअर इन्साइट्स नाव जस्ट अ क्विक क्वेश्चन हाऊ डू यू यू नो दिस एनी वन कॅन टेक ऑन द पॅनल यू नो वेन यू आर इट्स फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ओके सो थँक्यू सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल थँक्यू फॉर टेकिंग आर गोवन ट्रेडिशनल रेसिपीज ऑल अक्रॉस द कंट्री अँड इंटरनॅशनली अँड But one question arises is how do you take the traditional recipes and when you're commercially manufacturing it, how do you make sure that the authenticity of the taste remains? Is that one of the challenges that you find yourselves with? Anyone can take this question.
I can talk about Goan Fest. It is a challenge. And the only way you can solve it is through R&D. have literally, you know, developed and thrown away hundreds of recipes. So just to give you an example, the pickle that we have pickles of jackfruit, we have pickles of corunda, we have friendly pickle, chili pickle, all based on Google recipes. Now you have jackfruit pickle, which is common in East as well as North India, Katal ka achar. But we had to give it a Goan theme because, you know, we have some very excellent pickles in terms of taste profile in Goa. But then what you need, the challenges there are in the process itself, in terms of the spices that you use, timing, and the shelf life, the mix of spices that you use and impact on its shelf life. Even the stage at which you add that, the temperatures or the manufacturing process that we use. So it's a process of making and discarding, tasting it out, tasting the taste and the shelf life of the various items to finally come out with the right mix or the right recipe.
For me, I feel, I mean, anyways, we have created a product which is not out there in the market, so there's nothing to do with tradition or a taste profile. So it's for us to kind of take that R&D, as you rightly said, and understand the palate that has to be universal across the belts, not just within India itself. And I think it's also important at times, maybe a contrary view, we get stuck on traditions a lot, or traditional recipes a lot, but if you're trying to commercialize it and it's not adaptable, then there's no point of it. So if you want to commercialize it, you have to adapt it to something that will suit to the everyday, every person's palate, right? So taking those things into consideration, if it means, at least for our brand, when we do something like just a standard cashew miso, which can be within the vegan butter range and things like that, to replacing, say, a sesame paste that a lot of Asian cooking utilizes, or to use it within ice creams and other things. And then we create something which goes towards more of a modern take, because a lot of people now, at least the restaurants, I would say, utilize black garlic and other things. So it kind of takes into that profile where people are then attracted by the name or the packaging to at least try it out. Because just a cashew miso by itself typically doesn't, it's not going to, someone's going to look at it and be like, what do I do with it? So having those little, tweaks or twirls, same thing with the Goan pesto, right, for us to do. So I did this seminar for a bunch of, I think it was mostly Americans and British people. And it was mostly on like my fermentation journey with what I'm doing at Brown Koji Boy, but we were supposed to do a few recipes. So doing that Goan pesto actually clicked or connected with a lot of them, that you utilize something that is, great by itself, but like most people wouldn't adapt to. But then taking it next step, pesto is sort of universal in terms of understanding what it is, but then applying it that way also helps. So I think, yeah, with anything traditional or that dates back to centuries, is obviously important. But if it doesn't have that value that goes forward, then I mean, there's no real looking forward to it.
Thank you. Talking about trial and error, one thing that I have to share is, I was at Prachit's place one time and he was trying out this paneer. You had done something with fermented paneer. And that fermented paneer, it didn't work out exactly how we wanted to, but it was tasting like a fantastic blue cheese. Remember, we tasted it. And I was like, we created something new out of, with paneer. So it can sometimes work and create something new and exciting that you can then use as a blue chip dip or something like that.
Now we do sell it. We perfected that recipe.
So it actually turned out to become a product. Congratulations. Okay, so I think if anybody, now we'll open the floor to any questions anyone want to have. We have another 15 minutes to go. Hi, Sam. ना ना सामके कोकणी 100%
थँक्यू जाधव सर तुमका एक प्रश्न असा की आम्ही एदोच्यान डिस्कस केले काजूच्या बाबतीत की काजूच्या पासून बाबतीत रोस्टेड काजू अँड ड्रम रोस्टेड काजू दोन प्रकार असतात त्याका. ड्रम रोस्टेड काजू रोस्टेड काजू असतात नी त्यो टेस्टिक बरे लागतात, रिच इन टेस्ट टेस्ट. आणि जो ड्रम रोस्टेड असतात नी त्याका मातसो ऑइल असता, त्याका मातशी रिचनेस कमी असता त्याका, बरोबर न्ही? हा येस. ताज्या नंतर आम्ही कित्याचेर केले, फेणेचेर आमी डिस्कशन केले, फेणी हुर्राकाचेर केले डिस्कशन, आणि निऱ्याचेर केले. निरो निरो म्हणटा तो पहिलो प्रोडक्ट तो आम्ही एक आणि एक प्रोडक्ट जाता भितरल्यान जो प्री मॅच्युअर कॅज्यू असतात न्ही, प्री मॅच्युअर जो झाडा वयल्यान काडटात आम्ही हरवे असताना, आणि त्याका नाव त्याका म्हणतात बिबो. आणि बिब्याक ह्या डिमांड खूप असता मार्केटान, आणि तो सगळ्यान चड म्हारग असता, सगळ्यान चड, इट इज कॉस्टलियर दॅन ऑल दीस. आणि त्याका डिमांड चड असता, ते बियाचे भाजी म्हणून सुद्धा त्याचे उपयोग केलो जाता. तो एक बिब्याचो एक तुम्ही एक विषय एक तुम्ही घेऊन बिबो सुद्धा एक पार्ट ऑफ दॅट आयटम. त्याच्या नंतर आणि कोण असल्या उरलेले आता ना, तो तोच बिबो हो, बिबो हो भितर एक इन्क्लूड करपाक जाय. हय हय तशी न्ही. पण किती असा सर, किती असा बिबो म्हणतात तो हे करून किती सोलेलो बिबो म्हणतात त्याका, कळ न्ही? त्याका त्याका डिमांड चड असा मार्केटान. आणि मार्केटान येतात न्ही बिबे आता, तशी न्ही. पण बिबे बिबे येतात मार्केटान, अवेलेबल असा, तुम्ही पळयला असतले न्ही, तुम्ही हे करपाक शकना काय न्ही तुमकां अशें आसा. हय 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 हय
माइक माइक
डिड यू अंडरस्टँड द क्वेश्चन?
कितले लोक कितले फार्मर्सा कडल्यान तुम्ही तुमचे रॉ मटेरियल सोर्स आउट करता, तुमचो प्रोडक्ट करता, आणि किती प्राइस देता? कारण शेतकऱ्या बद्दल विचारू विचार, किती प्राइस देता मार्केटान? तांका आयज काजी 100 रुपया 120 रुपया किलो वता, तुम्ही किती देता?
आम्ही काजू जो असा काजूची बी ती आम्ही डायरेक्ट फार्मरा कडल्यान घेतात.
कितले फार्मर्स
आता आमचे येथून आता सगळे प्रोडक्ट दिले आले 50 वयर फार्मर्सचा कॉन्टॅक्ट असा आमच्या कडे.
तुम्ही कितलं प्रोक्युरियो करता?
प्राइस प्राइस किती देता म्हणता तुम्ही? प्राइस
काजू
काजू
काजू आम्ही त्यांचं किती प्राइस सध्या तरी आम्ही तो किती प्राइसान देतात तसेच घेता आम्ही, त्या प्राइसानीच घेतात सध्या काजू.
तरी तातून सस्टेनेबिलिटी किती उरली मॅडम? तातून सस्टेनेबिलिटी किती उरली? तुम्ही एक शब्द वापरलो सस्टेनेबिलिटी. ओके, जर म्हाका तुम्ही 120 रुपयान तर काजू घेता न्ही, कारण लँडिंग प्राइस ऑफ अ इम्पोर्टेड काजू इज अराउंड 60 to 70 rupees मेळटा. सस्टेनेबिलिटी म्हणता न्ही, एका शेतकऱ्यान तुमच्याकडे परत परत कित्याक लागून दिवचे, ज्यांना ताका एक फायदो मेळटा त्या प्राइस मेळटा. एका एंटरप्रनरान तुमच्या शेतकऱ्या कडल्यान कित्याक घेवचे? बट ही इज डॅम शुअर दॅट द सोर्स वॉट ही इज गेटिंग इज प्युअर अँड ऑथेंटिक. द इम्पोर्टेड व्हिएतनामीज ऑर समथिंग विच यू आर गेटिंग, यू डोंट नो वॉट इज इट. वन थिंग यू शुड एप्रिशिएट दॅट गोवन फार्मर केन्नाच काज झाडा वयल्यान तोडना, सकयल पडल्या उपरांतच तोडटा. सो दॅट दॅट्स द रिझन बिकॉज द नीश टायप ऑफ कॅज्यू आम्ही डेव्हलप करपाचे म्हणतात, बिकॉज द कर्नल इज फुल्ली डेव्हलप्ड वेन इट इज हार्वेस्टेड एज कम्पेअर टू वॉट इज डन इन महाराष्ट्र, कर्नाटका, ओडिसा ऑर आंध्र प्रदेश. दॅट इज गुड फॉर बटन कॅज्यू मिल कॅनॉल ते चिविल्ले काजू, बट गोवन फार्मर तसं केन्ना करणार. सो ऑब्विसली ही डिमांड ही रिक्वायर्स अ हायर डिमांड, दॅट्स वॉट आय वॉन्टेड टू आस्क यू. बिकॉज if anybody we want to suggest tomorrow, go to Govan one, because it should be something out of the box, different kind of aspal da tumhi jar tatun lanat karta ala shatka tumcha kadan yoch connect jarcho na, karan something kida da commercial angle poyna ka tumhi biodiversity manta dal tumhi
ande commercial
na tumcha commercial angle na tumhi manta ki biodiversity session hai tumhi traditional vapalle tumhi manta modern user technology tumhi use karta tatun traditionality kide
bolta traditional ani modern दोन्ही म्हणजे असे नाही की एकदमच ट्रेडिशनल, थोडे मॉडर्न गोष्टी जाय पडतात, टेक्नॉलॉजी थोडी इनकॉर्पोरेट करच्यो पडतात.
सो
हांव म्हणणार की सगळे सगळे फुल्ली ऑटोमेटेड असा, बट सेमी ऑटोमेटेड सिस्टम्स आम्ही यूज करतात. हँड क्युरेटेड प्रोडक्ट आम्ही, म्हणजे मेन फोकस पिकल्स बी असतात, सो देट वी कॅन यूज लेस मशिनरी, लेस एनर्जी रिसोर्सेस. आणि इवन ट्रेडिशनल प्रॅक्टिसीस कित्याक म्हणतात, कित्याक प्रेझर्वेटिव्ह आणि ह्यो गोष्टी असा त्यो कमी यूज जावचे. असे
लास्ट क्वेश्चन टू मिस्टर जाधव. There are four products what you have mentioned. With little knowledge about that, one is Birla and fifth one is Jackfruit. Apart from cashew, all these four products are highly perishable. They are climatic fruits. It means their shelf life is very in 1 or 2 days, not much than that. And ironically, out of these five products, four products are coinciding with the rainfall. Because they come up at the first monsoons. They are ready with that at the first monsoons. Most of them. Like jackfruit, kokum also.
Amba,
but Goan mangoes are not this thing. Goan, we are talking about Goan. But Goan mangoes only with three or four varieties, which leads up to June. Because that's, they are well for acquainted for that. So in regards to the, how many Goan farmers you look at, you are sourcing from your products? From the Goan thing for this particular raw material of this thing, and how they are benefited. Because why I'm asking you this thing, I don't feel bad with that, with no offenses. The only reason is that tomorrow if any farmer comes on to me, I should have something on platter to say that baba tumhi hanga basnaka, tumka bagaidaran jar ta 120 rupayan milta Goana kade chala 130 rupayan milta man sangpak mayapa jar भिडणा जर अशी पडून पाड जाता जाल्यार हांव शेतकऱ्यांक म्हणूंक शकता बाबा तूं भिडणा तूं पाड करनाका. गोवन फेस्ट आसा, तांकां कॉन्टेक्ट कर, ते येवन तुजे कडेन व्हरतल्यान ते फटाफट तुजे कडल्यान म्हणजे पोस्ट हार्वेस्ट लॉसीस कमी जातले. कन्सर्न इज दॅट इफ दॅट कॅन कम डाऊन, बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट टू लुक आउट फॉर दॅट. वी आर एक्सटेन्शन वर्कर्स, वी वड लाईक टू लुक आउट फॉर द फार्मर्स की हाव वी कॅन प्रोमोट इट. बिकॉज प्रत्येक फावटी एज मिस्टर सामंत इज अ कृषी रत्न, ही इज कन्सर्न विथ दॅट म्हाका माझ्या प्रोडक्टात किती प्राईस मेळटा का म्हणून. He is going down with his product, but he is not getting that price. Because when he goes in the market, he is lost. Because in the other entrepreneurs will prefer to have a lower price. And now if you, I don't want to comment on that. Now if you see the market, it is not a niche type of market, especially with regards to cashew. It is influxed with lot of the impurities which have come down, and it's totally polluted. And in the name of Goan Kazu, 10% Goan Kazu has to be 90% Bailo Kazu.
सर हे सगळीकडे चाललं. म्हणजे थोडा तो विषय कित्याक काढला, कारण हे आम्ही जे ओरिजिनली आम्ही काजू प्रोड्युसर्स असं हंगसरले, त्यांना काय मिळना. एका टायमार 170 रुपया किलो काज आशिल्ली, मान्य करतात नी तुम्ही, हा 170 रुपयात काज आशिल्ली, आणि आज ती काज आमकां 115 रुपया मेळटा. आणि ते सुद्धा आता सरांनी म्हटलं त्याप्रमाणे 65 to 70 रुपीज लँडिंग रेट, रॉ मटेरियलचा लँडिंग रेट असा.
हॅलो,
राईट क्वेश्चन, पण मी मराठी, पण आपण म्हणजे मेन इश्यू जो आहे आम्ही आमच्या परीने प्रयत्न करणार, पण त्याचं इम्पॅक्ट जो आहे तो लिमिटेड. ते प्राईज इश्यू जे आहे ते पॉलिसी लेवलवर हँडल करावं लागेल. आमचं कॉन्ट्रीब्युशन, आमच्यासारखे 50 जण जेव्हा उभे राहतील तेव्हा मार्केट त्याची काळजी घेऊ शकेल. अँड इट इज फ्रॉम माय साईड वी वेलकम कॉम्पिटिशन. लोकांनी यायला पाहिजे, काजूचे बोंडू प्रोसेस करायला पाहिजेत, नवे नवे प्रोडक्ट्स बनवायला पाहिजेत. ऑटोमॅटिकली त्याचा इम्पॅक्ट जे आहे, आज आम्ही 1.5 रुपया 1.5 रुपयाला बोलू घेतो, आमचं आम्हाला झाडावरूनच काढलेला लागतो कारण शेल्फ लाईफ कमी आहे, तर आम्ही देतो म्हणजे साखळी, वाळपोळी, बिचोली आणि कणकोम. सध्याचा आमचा बेल्ट हा आहे जिकडनं आमची फळं येतात आणि सरळ शेतकऱ्यांकडनंच येतात, शेतकऱ्यांकडनंच घ्यायला लागतात कारण याच्यात व्यापाऱ्याचं इंटरव्हेन्शन चालणार नाही. तसंच त्याच फार्मर्सची दुसरी, आता बिमलीचं कोणी कल्टिवेशन करत नाही असं नाही की बिमलीची बाग लावली आहे 5 एकर किंवा 10 एकर शेती बिमलीची कुणी करत नाही, दोन झाडं, तीन झाडं, चार झाडं अशी असतात, तर ते शेतकऱ्यांकडनं न्यूज सांगायला लागतं की बाबा आहे इथे मार्केट आहे. आज लोक पाहिली रस्त्यावर थोडीशी टोपली भरून विकायला बसलेले असतात. आमच्यासारखं कुणीतरी आलं की थोडं मोठ्या प्रमाणावर मार्केट क्रिएट होतं. म्हणजे एवढेशा वाटीतनं घेण्याच्या ऐवजी आम्ही टनांमध्ये घेऊ शकतो विक्री. आणि आमच्यासारखे 10 जण असले तर ऑटोमॅटिकली मार्केट त्या गोष्टींसाठी तयार होतं. फणस एक पर्टिक्युलर टाईम निघून गेला की म्हणजे माझा अनुभव आहे मागच्या 4-5 वर्षाचा, शेतकरी म्हणतात अरे घेऊन जातो मी, कुणीतरी आणून तोडून घेऊन जा फणस आणि मला त्याचे पैसे नको. पण वी आर क्रिएटिंग अ मार्केट, आम्ही पैसे देतो त्या गोष्टींसाठी. तर फायनली देर इज अ स्टेज की जिथं पॉलिसी इंटरव्हेन्शन चालू शकतात आणि देर इज स्टेज वेअर मार्केट कॅन टेक केअर ऑफ. आमच्यासारखे 10 जण आली की ऑटोमॅटिकली मार्केट क्रिएट होईल. आय होप मी म्हणजे थोड्याफार प्रमाणात उत्तर देऊ शकलो.
आम्ही शेतकऱ्यांना सांगू शकतो.
हो नक्की वेलकम.
देश तो आहे की असा आहे की हे एक विंडो ओपन आहे वेर यू कॅन सेल आउट योर प्रोडक्ट.
I am Mario Vimenda. I have 3 questions. So the first question is, other than food and beverages, what other things can be made from kaju based product, like in a fashion or medicine industry like that? My second question is, do kaju based products get government subsidies and benefits? And my third and final question is, does climate change affect your kaju based product business?
Could you just make it one question and ask specifically to any of the panelists so they can get like a combine the question and just ask one question, choose one that you want to answer.
I can say for outside of food and beverage, cashew oil can be used in a lot of skin care, medicinal care. You know, it's high in vitamins, it's high in specific, I'm not entirely sure because I'm not studied on that too much, but it's used in moisturizers quite a bit. So that is an industry where people can look at. It's also used as emulsifiers in paints. So that's where it can be utilized. Although obviously that's not something that we look at, so I can't comment too much into it. But those are the 2-3 things that I know outside of food and beverages.
But the outer shell which is there now, after removing the kernel, is used for making cow food.
Thank you very much. Are there any other questions or we can wind up the session now? Yes.
What about the issue of fake cashew, so-called fake cashew nuts? They are flour-based and I believe the market is flooded. It's been several years these things have been around.
The test is you put it in the water, that dissolves, whereas the cashew nut does not. And a lot of, there was actually a video done 2-3 years back that showed this machine producing so-called cashew,
so
look-alike.
I
don't know if there's any action. I mean, would you consider that as innovation or is it a...
No, so for this panel, I don't think this question might be pertinent because they are into innovation with the cashew nuts and or cashew products and how they are creating new things. So if you have anything pertinent to their industry, yes, madam.
She spoke about vegan cheese, right? Compared to the fruit or the nut or whatever she's using, and the vitamins and minerals and whatever is present in the raw stage of that nut or whatever, what happens when the cheese is made? Is it enhanced? What is the nutritive value of that cheese? And what is the value-based addition for that cheese? Has she got any analyzed information about this?
So what the cheese that I make out of cashew nut, it's not considered as very highly processed. So it is almost in its natural form. In fact, I soak the cashews overnight and that in fact makes, it breaks down the phytic acid in the cashew, which is harmful. And that also allows in more absorption of minerals, which are present in the cashew. So it's not processed to a level in which it is bad for you. So the nutrition level is still you know, available.
I'm not talking that it is bad. I'm saying, is it enhanced the value or is it destroyed, the minerals, whatever?
It is definitely not destroyed.
So have you got a test or testing done based on to find out?
We haven't got testing done. Like I said, it's what I use. It's not a factory-made product. It's almost like a home-based, you know, this thing. So it is not highly processed. That's what
because whenever you sell a product, when you're doing,
yeah.
You are sending it into the market that it is much better than what it could have been. So if you have that information, you could be doing a positive advertising,
yeah,
of your product,
yeah,
instead of just stating that I do this and I do that.
Yeah. So it is basically, for me, it's more in comparison with dairy. You know,
yeah,
when you compare it to dairy, counterpart of it, dairy can also, first of all, the dairy cheese available in the market are very processed. So there is literally not too much nutrition got from it, apart from all the bad things, you know, in dairy.
All the products these panelists have today introduced to us and spoken about, if you do have this information about the nutrition and value content of all these products, then it could go better in the market, because sometimes things come in the market and you are paying a high price for something which is nothing. And many times I prefer to eat my fruit raw,
yeah,
rather than in any processed form.
Yeah,
because,
yeah,
I'm sure of what I'm eating.
Yeah,
that's
absolutely.
Yeah. So that would be a future information.
Definitely,
that you could,
yeah,
be supplying
that
to us,
yes,
lab tested value,
for sure,
of these products. Thank you.
So thank you to all our panelists. This is quite an insightful discussion, and unfortunately we've run out of time now, but I want to express my gratitude to each one of you for sharing your expertise and experiences today. And to our audience, thank you for joining us. We hope you found this discussion enlightening, and until next time, thank you so much for giving us the opportunity.
Thank you, sir. Once again, thank everyone for this fruitful discussion, and we look forward to having you with us for our future events too. Now it is time for saying thanks and appreciate our panelists for their time, and as a token of appreciation, I request our DCF South Goa Division, Anand Jadhav sir, to present memento to our moderator for today's session, Prahlad Suktankar sir. Jadhav sir, I will request you only to present memento to Ms. Pooja Vellikar. Jadhav sir, please present memento to Prachit Sacheti. Next memento to Srimati Aparna Bhatia. And last but not the least, please present memento to Rajen Jadhav sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you everyone for being such an outstanding audience. This concludes our final session of Goa Kaju Fest Season 2. It is only because of your wholehearted participation that we at GFDC could conduct this technical session successfully. Just for information, during these 3 days panel discussions, we had privilege of listening to 30 panelists, and we had participation of more than 450 participants. So once again, I thank you one and all, and this concludes our final session. Request everyone to please join us for lunch outside. Thank you.